Please imagine that you travel back in time to the 1980s and find such a gift under the Christmas tree. Hi, nice to see you on this channel. Let's start again. Imagine that we are going back to the times of your childhood. What's under the Christmas tree? Santa Claus brought the Atari 2600 console. Incredible joy. What a fun. Your friends are definitely waiting to play games together on this device. Is that now time for Pac-Man? Moment. But is there anything else? More gifts? Yes, a console called Atari Flashback X. The Atari 2600 was introduced to the market in 1977, but the Atari Flashback X was launched in 2019. Thus, the Christmas tree can't be from the 1980s. Well, however, it is worth sometimes allowing yourself a moment of memories, of cherished memories. What are the characteristics of two at first glance similar devices that differ in production by 24 years? Let's check it out in this video. By the way, Christmas tree lights, baubles and other decorations were produced in Poland in the 1980s. Interestingly, the lights continue to shine without even having to replace a single light bulb for so many years. However, three spare ones were included in the set just in case. Oh, such additional retro elements in the video about Atari consoles. Returning, however, to the merits, Atari initially named its product VCS, which means Video Computer System, and later was given the number 2600 when the company launched a more advanced successor, 5200. It was one of the best-selling video consoles in history and, according to some sources, the best-selling second-generation console in the world. The estimated number of units sold, depending on the source, ranges from 25 to 30 million units. And that's at a time when these devices were really expensive in relation to earnings. Its huge popularity resulted in the creation of many clones of this device, both at the time when the console was produced and nowadays. One of the more interesting copies is a device called Atari Flashback X. So, let's get inside both devices, which means the original Atari 2600 and Atari Flashback X console, and let's compare how much technology has changed over the years. Let's add 42 years in the development of computer science and electronics. Before we begin to admire the beauty of integrated circuits, however, let's first take a look at the external appearance and the dimensions. They may seem seemingly similar, but the vintage console is much, much bigger. By putting a coin on both consoles, we'll have a point of reference. The main difference between consoles is the approach to their design. The Atari 2600 is an almost custom-made device with a specialized graphics and music chip not available for third-party devices. While Atari Flashback X is simplifying a typical smartphone but without a screen, however, with an HDMI connector, two joysticks ports and with Android installed. All is placed in a retro-style casing. In addition, the classic Atari does not contain any games and these are stored on cartridges, while the newer brother has quite a large selection in memory. Let's focus on the Atari 2600 VCS. It is also worth mentioning that Atari has released six major versions of the 2600 console and it's the third one presented in the video. On the front panel we have switches and a slot for inserting a cartridge with games and a few programs. As for example even a simple basic interpreter is available. Earlier versions of the console have two additional switches on the front panel, which are not visible here, and which later went to the back panel, used to select the difficulty level for two players. The rear panel also has an antenna cable for connecting to a TV set, and an additional switch to select one of the two channels on which the signal can be broadcast. Of course, the image is broadcast in the analog PAL, NTSC or SICAM system. An unusual thing is that the antenna cable is not connected to the socket on the housing, but came straight from the inside. Let's move on the Atari Flashback X. You can see a great similarity here, although of course we have an HDMI connector for connecting to a monitor or TV. Interestingly, 9-pin joystick ports were left in the standard of the old Atari. Thus, these are not USB ports, as many people would expect. Additionally, they support also the famous paddles, which means controllers, where the player's position on the screen is determined by the rotation of the knob coupled with a potentiometer. The information itself is transmitted in analog way, so the position is in practice determined by the voltage value. However, probably everyone is already waiting to get to the interior of the devices. Let's do it now! The main board of the Atari 2600 console is made in the classic through-hole technology technique, in abbreviation THT. The elements have long wire feet that are inserted into the holes made in the PCB and of course soldered later. At the time when the legendary console was produced, it was the primary assembly method. Although of course it was also partially automated in case of devices made on a large scale. Now let's take a look at the Atari Flashback X. The difference can be seen at first glance. The board is made in the surface mount technology, in abbreviation SMT. On the other hand, the elements themselves are called surface mount devices, in short SMD. The elements are placed on the board and fixed in the soldering process, and the larger ones are additionally glued to the board before soldering, with a special glue resistance to high temperatures. In addition, some chips, such as the main microprocessor and RAM memory, have housings in the technology with spherical lids in the ball grid array, or in short BGA. To put it simply, they are multi-filled housings that are connected to the PCB by means of many microscopic balls of solder. Of course, the technologies used in Atari Flashback X have been designed for automatic assembly of components by specialized devices. As a result, repair by amateur electronic engineers is much more difficult and requires more experience, although of course it is still possible. Please also note that the Atari Flashback X PCB has components on both sides, while the Atari 2600 PCB has only on one side. The Atari 2600 is based on the iconic MOS 6502 microprocessor, here in the 6507 version prepared especially for this model, which can be briefly described as the poorer and slimmer brother. The chip television interface adapter, or in short TIA, is responsible for graphics, sound generation and a few additional functions such as the support for the famous paddles. We also have a MOS 6532 RAM I/O timer chip called Riot. It provides a small amount of RAM and is responsible for handling input-output circuits, which means for switches on the device housing and for digital lines of two joystick ports, and includes a simple programmable counter allowing to measure the time. The console has no ROM at all, as the entire software is contained in the cartridge. Now let's take a look at the newer Atari Flashback X console. Unfortunately, despite long searching, I did not find any schematic diagram of this device. However, I was able to determine some of the information. The main microprocessor is the ROG chip RK3066A chip, which provides most of the required functions. It includes a Cortex-A9 dual-core ARM processor, two types of cache, L1 and L2, internal non-volatile flash memory containing a handler, updatable. Add to that the built-in Mali 400 graphics chip, as well as the ability to encode and decode video streams. There is also of course an audio chip. In addition, support for devices such as pen drives or SD cards is provided. Additionally, it has an internal clock, an HDMI port handling module, as well as analog to digital converters used here to operate the paddles. In a word, an almost complete computer in one integrated circuit. At the time this video is being made, it is a model with fairly average capabilities. However, when comparing to the historical console, the difference is huge. Really huge. The microprocessor works with DDR3 SDRAM memory as well as with NAND flash memory, in which the main operating system is properly stored, which means Android, appropriately modified for the needs of the device and games provided by the manufacturer. Now let's take a small comparison of a few selected elements of both devices. If anyone is interested in the subject, it is easy to find more professional and more detailed information. First, the microprocessors, real silicon brains. Then take a look at how much the discrete elements have changed. Time for resistors. The ones designed for THC mount are completely different than the ones for SMT mount. For the less informed, these are the elements used to limit the current. The voltage drop that occurs is directly proportional to the current flowing through the resistor. Please take a look that the classic elements have a color code indicating their resistance and tolerance, which means possible deviation from the expected value, optionally an additional temperature coefficient. Why SMD components have strings describing their parameters, or where they are very small like here, they don't have any text at all. Then, to determine their resistance, a schematic diagram of the device or measurements on the board is necessary. If a given resistor is faulty, you can measure the resistance of analogous good resistors if you can see repeating fragments of the diagram. Sometimes, in case of a defective resistor, when not having a schematic diagram of the device, they are selected based on experience. It also happens that one is looking for a second non-working device, for example a second computer motherboard of the same type, and after checking whether the selected element is functional, it is transferred to the motherboard being repaired. Finally, it is worth adding that the parameters of SMD components are not written in plain text, but with the code, which is very easy to learn. Time for capacitors. To put it simply, it is an element made of two conductors separated by a dielectric and used to accumulate electric charges. Here, in the case of elements both for THC and SMT mounting, the capacitance of the capacitor and the maximum operating voltage can be read from the inscription on it. Similarly, in case of small SMD components, the inscriptions are often absent. Additionally, for electrolytic capacitors, the negative plate is marked. But for the rarely used tantalum capacitors, the positive plate is marked. And who invented this? Next, the diodes. To put it simply, they conduct current primarily in one direction. We distinguish many different types. They are the ones fulfilling other functions, such as light-emitting diodes or Zener diodes used in voltage and current stabilization systems. Now briefly about transistors. They act, figuratively speaking, as a kind of small electronic switches. And finally, quartz oscillators. They will take advantage of the piezoelectric effect. They are the source of the reference frequency at the timing signal. Figuratively speaking, they define the rhythm in which the devices on the board should work, like a drummer playing the drum. Of course, this short and very simplified electronic course presents only a small degree of how electronic components work. However, my videos are watched by both beginners and more experienced people. I hope that experts will forgive me for presenting the principles of electronic components operation in such a short summary. In conclusion, today's devices are unfortunately so designed and manufactured that their repair is an increasing challenge. Do you find such a comparison of two devices from the two different galaxies interesting? Finally, something for real tough guys watching videos to the end. Two interesting facts. The first is a photo of the Atari 2600 prototype made in 1975. The second are drawings from the patent application for the Atari 2700 console, which was to be the successor of the device presented in today's video. They show wireless controllers. Unfortunately, Atari 2700 was never brought to the market. However, controllers in a slightly modified form began to be sold as peripheral device with the symbol CX42 intended for the 2600 console. Stay healthy!